Did you kind of call him out?
I did a little bit yesterday. I went up to him. I asked him how it was if he was deployed in 67 to 69 with SEAL Team 4 when they weren't commissioned till 83.
Okay. And you're the Army guy? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Hand the phone and say, hey, talk to a fellow Navy guy.
All right.
Hey, Bruce. Old Navy buddy of mine wants to holler at you. He's on
paper. Yeah, go ahead.
Bruce.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm an old bosun mate, shipmate. How are you?
All right. Bosun mate, what ship are you on?
I was on the Lockwood, the McKee, assault craft unit, all kinds of stuff. Understand. Go ahead.
I know a lot of people. It was on the L.Y. Sphere, the Puget Sound, USS Albany, and the USS Sample. There was a frigate resting with tender was the guy, and a guy to missile proof.
Would you believe I married a bosun mate off the USS McKee? Prettiest bosun mate in the whole Navy.
Well, I didn't know that.
One of the first women on Navy ships. Yep, that's for sure. So, She's bosun mate, son's a bosun mate, a whole bit. I understand that the problem on that website is you don't have any other Navy guys. You got some skeptical Army dude.
Yeah.
It's a pleasure speaking to you. I'm honored, sir. Navy SEAL Vietnam.
Yeah. That's true. A lot of stuff I had to do.
Also heard some about Afghanistan.
Yeah, I was there in Iraq in 88, and I seen what was going on. I had enough to do with the paperwork.
I'm sorry. Still struggling to hear you a bit.
Oh, I said I put the paperwork in. I was out in Afghanistan back in 88. And 89, about the tail end of 88, beginning of 89, that's when I put my paperwork in.
Well, you're getting a little old for some of that.
Yeah, sure am getting too old.
Yep, there you go. So, what SEAL team in Vietnam, sir? I think that's where the confusion came. I'll try to help.
Okay, they had SEAL team 2 went in. I was SEAL team 1 and 2. 2 was just about wiped out because of all the stuff that was going with disadvantage and do away with SEAL Team 2. But everybody with SEAL Team 2 transferred over to SEAL Team 4 out of Little Creek.
Wiped out as in killed?
What?
Wiped out as in killed?
No, it's just, man, yeah, not all of us, but they just eventually wiped, just abandoned it. Then they were going to start it back up. I don't know if they ever did or not, but it was transferred to SEAL Team 2.
Oh.
From 2 to 4.
So, where were you stationed at? In total?
Little Creek, Virginia.
With 2? With Team 2?
With Team 2, I went and stationed in a little bit, Virginia.
There you go. So, I think probably what has happened with that Army guy, you know how Army guys are.
Yeah.
It's that story about the rape, killing women and children, sir? Is that a fact?
Well, you do what you had to do when the survivor, put it the other way.
That thing about the your buddy raping, were they already dead when he was raping them?
Well, I've had 2 or 3 buddies that were caught, but they took them to the tunnel, tied them up, and rats got them.
Tied them up and rats got them?
Yeah, you never seen that done?
No.
And that's what they did over there.
Well, why would they do that?
Well, if you don't. Why would they do that? You have to dead me. Why would they do that? That's sometimes they're a bit bigger. But they do get some of the same punishment that they had to get back with them.
And I think part of the problem is perhaps some of those stories shouldn't be shared to the civilian population or Army guys. They're pretty gruesome, sir. I don't know that it does the Navy a whole lot of good.
Well, it's just like a few Army guys I met. That's some of everybody's got tied up in the pits and stuff. What they do, they starve those rats, and then they tie you down, let the rats eat you.
Well, gruesome again, sir. How long were you over in Vietnam?
I was over 2 years.
Two years? two straight years?
Yep. I have done 18 months pure.
Ouch. Man, how many guys did you lose?
I don't know what all. I can't tell you the exact figure how many you lost.
Okay. I'll help you out, sir. Do you recall a SEAL training class number?
Yeah. That was 1064.
1064?
Yep.
That's actually the hull number to the USS Lockwood that I served on, FF 1064.
Yeah.
I didn't know that they had. Go ahead.
That was one of the numbers on
I didn't know they had training classes that went up that high. I thought they kind of started numerically at one.
Well, during that age, it's from 1960. Back to from 62 on up is a little bit different than the good time.
1064, did that number represent that something? Was the class behind you?
That was the class. That was the class in Florida.
So the class before yours was 1063?
I don't know what that class was.
The class ahead of you was 1065?
I think so. I can't remember. It's been done that. It's been 40, almost 40, 50 years.
Yeah, well, I know about that. Now, I was looking at this list of SEALs. I didn't see your name listed up there as ever being one, sir.
I know.
Classified stuff?
Well, I was in there. I went through trainings.
I did the whole bosun mate thing in the Navy, but in 1984, I went to Bud's training, became a SEAL. I retired as a SEAL senior chief bosun mate. My Bud's class was 131. Vietnam era guys were, you know, in the 40s and 50s. There was no 1064 training classes.
Well, that's what I was in. It's been so damn long, I don't remember all this shit.
Yeah, I get that quite a bit too. So, these stories down there telling those guys that and that your name isn't listed. How about the, can you give me the guys? Go ahead.
Well, I'll go right ahead and say something. Told anything what we did over there.
Yeah. How about
that? That was kept secret, to be honest with you. If you went back to going regular administration, did you ever go to the office back to Argentina down through that way?
No.
Since you were a SEAL?
To Argentina?
Yeah, down through that way during Reagan administration, during the drug deal.
No.
Down through that way, South America, up through that way.
No, I left SEAL training in San Diego and went right to SEAL Team 1. And 4 years later, I transferred to SEAL Team 2 and basically retired in Little Creek. SEAL Team 2 was the first commissioned SEAL team.
Right.
Only because of the time zones. President Kennedy commissioned Team 2 on the East Coast.
That was back in 1962 when they commissioned it.
That's right. I read some of those. And you were on that? At what year, sir?
I was in there in 1963, 64, 65.
At Team 2, I've got you down as what that guy had told me is... You were there in 66 to 69 in Vietnam with Team 4. That's when they changed?
When they changed over.
I can tell you've studied a little bit about these SEAL teams, knowing that 1962.
No, I haven't studied nothing.
Yes, well, I got news for you, sir. SEAL Team 2 and SEAL Team 1 were the only SEAL teams that operated in Vietnam. And
Vietnam.
SEAL Team 4 was not commissioned until
1983, I think, or 84 they were
commissioned. That's right, SEAL Team 3 and SEAL Team 4, but they never changed the numbers. Like I said, I was at Team 2. They didn't change anything.
Team 2, what year? What year were you down there in Vietnam?
Oh, 89 to 2001.
So you didn't serve in Vietnam, did you?
No. Does that make me? So I'm getting that all wrong?
No, there's a lot of things you've got wrong. But you didn't serve in Vietnam. How old were you?
I'm sorry, sir?
How old are you?
57.
You didn't serve well, did you? Well, 10 years early, 10 years between the night.
No, it's Don Shipley, sir. Have you ever heard of me?
No, not really.
No. And you study that SEAL history enough, you'll find out who I am kind of real quick, sir. I'm a walking historian of naval special warfare from World War II, Korea, Vietnam, all up to present day. I look at a simple database, a complete listing of every guy since 1943, and there's no one by your name listed. The closest is a Walton. There's no Alton up there. And your BUDS class or SEAL training class, or back then it was called UDT.
UDT training. That's true. You're right on that.
Yeah, UDTR, UDTB, UDTRA. Yeah, I got all that. And there's no 1064, sir. Those numbers were in the 30s, 40s, 50s.
That was during when Vietnam. Okay, with the CDs, they got that. Remember Don Shields?
The CBs?
Yeah, I was over there with some of them too. And you remember the Don Chill, the CBs, 1060, I think 1060. I don't want you the CBs, they were fighting all together. And Don Shields, when he got killed?
Who?
Don Shields.
Don Shealy, a SEAL?
No, he wasn't a SEAL, he was a CB. He was working, he was beside a bunch of us CBs.
A bunch of us CBs? Is that what you just said, sir?
No, I just said CB and SEALs.
Why would CBs be fighting with SEALs, sir? It's apples and oranges.
They weren't. They were getting overrun by a unit.
By the VC.
A construction deal. They were overrunning that. And Don Shields stood there and fought for a long time with the SEALs. And the SEALs fought with them to hold that ground at that position.
I tell you, how about if you give me the name of that guy that was raping those dead women, and I'll check his name here. Do you have that?
No, I still don't.
You remember your commanding officer at SEAL Team 2 or SEAL Team 4? Can you name any other SEAL that I can pull in?
What do you want?
Can you name any other SEALs, sir, that you served with?
I can name a lot.
Okay, give me one name. Spell the last name, sir.
Who is it? Don Chip. I don't know Don Chip.
Call people out. You make that SEAL. You around here with a Stolen Valor bullshit.
Stolen Valor bullshit.
It's Stolen Valor bullshit. He checked the SEAL database. You're not in the SEAL database.
Well, I've been.
I don't believe. I don't doubt you've been there, but you wasn't there as an Navy SEAL. You're pulling off shit that you never part of. I ain't stuff you do, especially around other veterans that can call you on your bullshit.
Oh,
I don't appreciate it because I served and I had a lot of buddies die.
I did too. Had a lot of.
Mine really died there.
Oh,
I'm talking about real people.
I had a lot
people that I stood beside, slept with. Why is it that all the bullshit you're telling me he don't find in his database?
I don't know what he does with database.
He's got a database of every SEAL that ever was since the SEAL started.
What we done over there wasn't supposed to be told to do.
Then why is your name not in the SEAL database?
A lot of things.
No. It doesn't.
Okay, it's not in the SEAL database. Just take it in.
I know it's not in the SEAL database because you wasn't a Navy SEAL. You're pulling off a bunch of bullshit. I know you're not pulling it off. You tried to pull it off, but you ain't.
I'll let you learn, but I ain't gonna tell you what we did.
I don't want to know what you did. I just want you to know that I know that you're not a Navy SEAL. Stolen Valor is a serious thing to other veterans.
I know.
So I'd appreciate it if you didn't pull that bullshit no more.
Okay, I'll take it to that. I'll take it to that.
That's fine with me.
Okay.
So where are we leaving this one?
I don't know. I guess he's going to stick with his story and get the hell off his job site. I guess what's going to happen.
Did he leave?
Not yet, but he's going to.
Well, is he right there? Is he still on?
He's still here.
Yeah, there wasn't anybody operating in Afghanistan. That was a Russian conflict. Sir, that's total bullshit. And you'd have needed a walker to get around there in 88. SEAL Team 2 and SEAL Team 1. So many of you clowns claim I served at Team 3 or Team 4 in Vietnam, and that's total bullshit. Those guys were not there. They weren't in existence. And this bit about killing women and children and your buddy raping them and rats is doing no justice to the United States military nor serving the Navy in any capacity whatsoever. They're horrible, despicable stories, and you ought to be ashamed of yourself telling that bullshit to that Army vet over there and all this stuff that he's done. I bet you were a CB or you served in the galley on some fucking scowl in the U.S. Navy, but you were never a SEAL. Water demolition, and that 1064 signifies something. When I get done here, I'm going to search CB 1064 and see if some shit comes up. But that ain't even close to any Bud's class. Got to take that back. And the other thing, when you die, sir, your wife or next of kin is going to write your obituary and put that down that you were a SEAL in Vietnam, and I'm going to get a hold of that damn thing and make sure that everybody knows that's bullshit. You need to quit telling them fucked up stories. Anything else?
No.
Yeah, tell him to go Google Phony Navy SEAL of the Week. He'll be up there soon. Okay, bro. Are we done here?
Yes, sir. I've read it, Mr. Shipley.
Yeah. Stay safe. Watch that clown. No telling what else he's got going on.
All right.
Always
you too.
Something with these guys. See ya, bro.
See ya. Bye.
It's early in the morning, and that's a young Army guy, an electrician. He's on a job site in North Carolina with this loudmouth down there talking. He's been going back and forth with me. The guy claims he's a member of SEAL Team 4 in Vietnam in 66 to 69, in Afghanistan in 88 and 90. It wasn't shit going on. There was nobody over in Afghanistan operating and shit. And he's just nothing, none of it works. So when I tell him that, I write him back and I say, SEAL Team 4 wasn't even commissioned until 1983. The last SEALs left Vietnam in November of 1972, and only Team 1 and Team 2 were in existence in Vietnam. So he confronts that guy. And he tells him that back then it was Team 2, but they changed the numbers in the 80s to Team... They changed the numbers of SEAL Team 2, but I don't flippin' think so. I was there. He's bragging about how he killed women and children, and his buddy used to shoot women, then rape them. I don't think I've even had a full cup of fucking coffee yet. My blood pressure is, I need flipping medicated. I've had enough of these guys. I'm sure when he slipped up, they always do. I'm sure there's something to that CB unit, us CBs, 1064. I'll figure that out real quick, but that guy's up my fucking nose in a fucking huge way this morning. Fucking clowns, let's just see real quick. That's just anger. That bullshit Bud's class number 1064, talking about CBs. I haven't exactly found 1064 yet, but I've found 10s all the way around this shit. This is 1067. It's a CB detachment. That's where they get that shit from. You got to listen real close to what these motherfuckers tell you. 1064 was a CB detachment. And I'm searching it in Vietnam, and I'm not finding anything. I don't think he ever stepped foot in that country. We'll find out. Rats. Let rats eat them. Are you fucking shitting me? Are you fucking shitting me? Bunch of fucking... Allowing rats to eat women? Are you shitting me? Are you fucking shitting me? And that's what you're running around fucking telling people? There's a SEAL? You were letting rats eat women in fucking Vietnam? Tying him down, you motherfucker. You motherfucker, man. Ooh.